Hey, hello viewers, a warm welcome to each and everyone, and it's an immense pleasure to see you all. And this is JN Group of Schools, Purukkote and Trichy, one of the best schools in Purukkote. You all know very well that we are facing our many great difficulties in this corona pandemic period. We have devised methodologies for our students to learn their lessons without any hindrances from their home itself. And also now we are providing online classes and online tests through our own licensed platform, Google Meet. Also, we provide online videos from our prestigious online educator, Baidu's. And those videos are completely free for students. As a next step to help our students who don't have advanced 4G mobile, we are providing recorded online videos. To watch those video classes, you may visit our YouTube channel, The Little Angel, Jairani Meditation School, Purukkote. And all those videos will be updated in our YouTube channel itself. And these videos also will be sent to our students' WhatsApp group. And students, please watch those videos regularly and get its benefits. And also, if you have any doubts, you can clarify it on our online classes itself. And don't miss it, my dear students. And last but not the least, be safe, wash your hands regularly, maintain social distance and wear masks. Always have healthy food and drink more water. And dear viewers, soon we'll catch you in our next videos. Until then, this is JN Group of Schools signing off. Bye-bye, see you and take care.
Hi students, today we are going to see about the chapter Python. Python is a programming language only. For what purpose we using Python? And who created Python? And which year Python released? Reason. What is the main important points of Python is, it's a general purpose in programming language invented by Guido van Rossum, and this language was released in 1991. How we got the name Python? From BBC comedy series from 70s, the name was Monty Python Flying Circus. From that we get a name of Python. Python supports both procedural and object-oriented programming approaches. What are the key features of Python? Listen. It is a general programming language used for both scientific and non-scientific programming. And it is a platform independent programming language. The program written in Python are easily readable and understandable. Nowadays, we're using a version 3.x of Python. None other, it's an integrated development learning environment used to develop and write the Python code. How can you write a Python programming languages? By two ways, interactive and script mode. How you write an interactive mode in Python? By using a command prompt shift write. And what are the file extensions to save a Python means .py. Interactive mode, I already informed you, that is a coding. How can you invoke it in Python? Start all program Python 3.x by going IDLE. You can start writing your coding. And script mode. Script mode means it's a text file containing a Python statement and it are reusable code. And you can execute again and again without retyping. In Python, script or editable. Next, we're going to see about input and output function. For what purpose we're using input and output function in Python? Input used to accept the data at a runtime. So for that purpose, we're using a syntax as an input. So listen, what is the syntax for input function? Variable equal to input in the parenthesis, you must use a prompt string. Next, output function. For output function, all over you want to use to display the result of the program on the screen. For that, we're using a function named print. Commands in Python. What are the commands we are using in Python is hash. The line that begins with hash are considered as command and ignored by the Python. Command may be a single line or no multiple line. The multiple command should be enclosed within a set of hash. Indentation. Indentation means it uses wide spaces such as space and tabs. The program blocks, whereas other languages in C, C++, Java use curly braces to indicate a block of code for class, function, or body of loops and block of statement or selection commands. What are the tokens we are using in Python? Identifiers. Keywords, operators, literals, delimiters. Identifiers means used to identify a variable, function, class, model, or object. How can it start? It starts with alphabet or underscore. Also, it contains digits. In Python, identifiers are case sensitive, must not use any keyword. And it also allows the punctuate characters also. Keyword. Keyword or special words used to Python interpreter to recognize the structure of the program. Examples, class, def, del, if, etc. These are the keywords we are using in Python. Operator. I think so, you already studied in C++. What are the operators? Arithmetic, logical, relational, assignment, conditional operators. Already we saw in C++. Just we will discuss how to use these operators and symbols in Python. What are the symbols we using in arithmetic operator? In arithmetic operator, for mathematical operators, performs on calculations such as A plus B, A minus B, multiplication. That means addition, subtraction, multiplication, modulus. These are the operator we are using in arithmetic operator. By in Python, you must use each and every operators before shift left. This is a main, shift right. This is a main symbol you need to use before the operators, relational operator. What are the relational operator? Is also known as a comparative operator. Relation between two operands, to check the relation between two operands. If the relationship is true, it returns true. Otherwise, it returns false. See what are the symbols? Equal to, greater than, lesser than. Logical operator. Logical operators are already we studied in C++. It is a decision maker. What are the operator and how can you use an expressions in it? Or and not. These are the logical operator. Assignment operator means it use the operators to assign the value to variable by using the symbols equal to, plus equal to, minus equal to, etc. Conditional operator is also known as ternary operator. Evaluate something based on condition. It's been true or false. It followed by the syntax. If the condition is true, if statement will be executed. Otherwise, it goes to else statement. What is delimiters? Delimiters means the symbols and symbol combinations. That means plus, minus, parenthesis, square brackets, curly braces. Literals. What are the types we are using in literals and what purpose we are using in literals? It's a raw data given in a variable or constant. What are the types? Numeric, string, and Boolean. What are the Python data types? Python data types are numeric, Boolean, and string. Numeric means the object in Python supports integer, floating, and complex number. Integer supports decimal, octal, hexadecimal, likewise. Boolean, we already know there will be only two values in booleans, that is true or false. String. String data can be exposed only the characters, but using a single, multiple or triple quotes is called a string data type. These are the languages, data types, operators we are using in Python languages. In next class, we will discuss about what are the control statements we are using in Python. Thank you so much for watching my video.